everyone, and a very warm welcome to WS CubeTech. So guys, in our previous session, we have learned about request library, and in today's session, we will be talking about how we can obtain HTML of any website using Beautiful Soup. So guys, we will start using our Beautiful Soup today onwards. That this is the library which we are going to exactly use for scraping the data. So this is the first library which we will be using. After this, we will be also working with the Selenium, but for now, we will be working with the Beautiful Soup. So we will first understand that how we can get the HTML of a website using Beautiful Soup. We have previously done it with the help of request library. Today we will be doing it with the Beautiful Soup, because at the end, with the help of Beautiful Soup only, we will be extracting that data. So let's have a look on how it can be done. So here I'll import request library, and I'll also import that from BS4 import Beautiful Soup. So we will be importing both of our libraries. Again, we will be passing a URL over here. For URL, we will be writing a variable called as URL. Here you can create, you can open your browser and you can go for any link. Let's copy this one for WS CubeTech, and I'll paste it over here. To get a response, we will write r is equals to requests.get. And here we will pass our URL. After this, we will print R. If you directly print R, you will still get the response over here. So here we will get the response as 200. That means we can get the HTTP. And here, now what we need to do. So previously we have learned how to get a text from here. Okay, but this was not structured. It was unstructured data. If we want a structured data, for that, with the help of Beautiful Soup, we will be getting this data in the format of a string. And then by using the functions of the Beautiful Soup, we can extract the data by finding different tags here. So for tags and what are all these other things, don't get confused. In our next session, we will be talking about some of the elements of HTML, where I will be explaining you what are tags, what are attributes, what are headers and all these things. Okay. As of now, let's just understand that. Let's go back here on our website, and here you can see this is our HTML data. And if I want to get it, simply all I need to do is let's just remove this and write. Now here we will be using soup is equals to, okay, why this library's name is Beautiful Soup, because it deals with our XML or let's say HTML data, and inside this we have different things, like we have tags, we have attributes, we have headers, we have strings, and all those different things are there. And okay, just like how inside the soup we have different veggies, so similarly how in XML, that means how in HTML data, we have all these different things. That's why it's called as Beautiful Soup, I guess. So that is why we will be writing Beautiful Soup. Inside the Beautiful Soup, we will be passing our dot text comma, and we will be dealing with the HTML files here, so that's why we will be passing lxml. Once we are done with this, and here we will print our soup. Let's run and see what output we'll get. So as soon as I now run it, I'll be getting this in our Beautiful Soup. So this is how you can obtain the HTML data from your any website and get it over here using Beautiful Soup. Now, once we are done with this, we will be using the functions of Beautiful Soup to extract different things from here. So as you can see, if I talk about this website only, we have different things over here. So let me just scroll it down for you. And here we have maybe somewhere something important that, okay, let me just search a little bit. Close button, primary, okay. Okay, here we have courses.wscubetech.com. So maybe our page will start from here. And we have get started button, we have log into existing account, create new account. You can see different titles are there over here. So what we will be doing, we will be extracting the data from here only, because now the whole data is here in our Python, and it is very simple. By using the Beautiful Soup's amazing function, it's very easy to extract the data now. So as of now, you just need to understand this, that by using this method, we can extract the HTML of any website. So if I open this, so majorly for Beautiful Soup, initially we will be using a test website. So here we will be writing web scraping test sites. And if you click on this, the first link will be the one which we will be using. You can open this. We have different options over here. We have e-commerce site with pagination links. And then we have e-commerce site with pop-up links. And there are different options over here. Let's go with the first one. The first one is the very basic and the simple one. So let's just click it. As soon as I click it, it's an e-commerce website for computers and phones. And it's just a test website. It has tablets, laptops, and you can, you know, just again click on inspect. And you can see the data associated with different things. All you can see right now over here is, like, suppose if I click here, you can see some div is there, some image is there. Okay, you just don't need to understand this in depth. All you need to understand as of now is that we are getting what the HTML by just passing this link. So I'll just copy this link from here and I'll paste it in our URL. And again, the response of this website is 200. And if I get the soup of this one, this is how it looks like. So here you can see we have ASUS VivoBook E52NA G0 and G0022T and something like that. So this is how you can, you know, extract, you can get the data in our Python. And later with the help of our beautiful soups functions, we will be extracting this data. So I hope guys that as of now it is clear that how we can get the data, how we can get the HTML using beautiful soup. In our next session, we are going to talk about tags in our HTML. So stay connected guys and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.